Hey, this is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, here to talk about a class of antibiotics called fluoroquinolones. The fluoroquinolones that are commonly used within the outpatient and inpatient setting include ofloxacin, ciprofloxacin, levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, and norfloxacin. The fluoroquinolone group of antibiotics have an interesting property compared to other antibiotics, as these are the only antibiotics that directly inhibit bacterial DNA synthesis. How do the fluoroquinolones inhibit bacterial DNA synthesis? Well, these antibiotics work on the enzymes DNA gyrase and topoisomerase 4. These enzymes are involved in the winding and unwinding of DNA. DNA gyrase and topoisomerase 4 aid the unwinding of DNA so it can be read and replicated. With the inhibition of these enzymes, bacteria are unable to replicate and, more importantly, are unable to produce proteins they need for survival. As a result, the fluoroquinolone class of antibiotics are bactericidal, meaning that they actually lead to bacterial cell death. Now, what organisms are targeted by fluoroquinolones? All the fluoroquinolones generally affect aerobic gram-negative bacilli and gram-negative cocci. Examples of gram-negative bacilli include Enterobacteriaceae and Haemophilus. Examples of gram-negative cocci include Neisseria and Moraxella. In addition, fluoroquinolones can also work against Pseudomonas and Staph aureus. Now, the strength of each of the fluoroquinolones on bacteria vary from each medication. For example, norfloxacin, ciprofloxacin, and ofloxacin have poor activity against streptococci and many anaerobes. Moxifloxacin has greater activity against anaerobes. Both levofloxacin and moxifloxacin have good activity against gram-positive cocci. In terms of treating Pseudomonas, ciprofloxacin tends to have the best activity against Pseudomonas. Moxifloxacin and levofloxacin tend to have less anti-pseudomonal activity. Now, ciprofloxacin is so frequently used that many areas of the country have seen a significant surge of Pseudomonas resistance to ciprofloxacin. So it really is important to know what are the bacterial resistances that are present in your community. In terms of respiratory infections, all the fluoroquinolones are generally effective. However, both levofloxacin and moxifloxacin have better strep pneumonia coverage than the other fluoroquinolones. Now that we talked about the bacterial coverage of the fluoroquinolones, it's important to talk about how these drugs are absorbed and cleared. Fluoroquinolones are absorbed well in the upper GI tract. One of their advantages is that they have a bioavailability that exceeds 50% and actually reaches 100% in some cases. This means for some fluoroquinolones, administering IV provides no greater bioavailability than administering it orally. Specifically, bioavailability for Cipro is 70%, greater than 95% for ofloxacin and levofloxacin, and greater than 85% bioavailability for moxifloxacin. Though the fluoroquinolones are absorbed through the GI tract, they have different routes of elimination. Ofloxacin and levofloxacin are renally eliminated. Moxifloxacin is eliminated predominantly by the liver, and Cipro is commonly excreted by both pathways. It's important when administering any medication that one understands the risks and adverse effects of the medication. In pregnant women, fluoroquinolones have not been established as safe, and more research really needs to be done. That being said, quinolones should be avoided in children less than 18 years old because there have been reports of joint cartilage erosions in animal studies. The concerns are these antibiotics will lead to detrimental outcomes in a child's growth. What are the side effects associated with fluoroquinolone use? Well, fluoroquinolones are associated with an increased risk of developing C. diff colitis as these antibiotics clear the normal bowel flora. More recently, fluoroquinolones have been found to cause a peripheral neuropathy. If this occurs, they should be stopped and switched to a different class of antibiotics. The neuropathy can last for months to years and occasionally can be permanent. Fluoroquinolones have been associated with tendinopathy and tendon rupture. Those highest at risk were greater than 60 years old, non-obese females, and were using glucocorticoids. In addition to tendinopathy, fluoroquinolones can cause QT interval prolongation due to the inhibition of potassium channels. Moxifloxacin and ciprofloxacin were associated with increased rates of cardiac arrhythmias, though ciprofloxacin was not associated with an increase in cardiovascular mortality. Patients who are elderly, female, or have QT prolongation at baseline are at greatest risk. Rarely, hepatotoxicity can occur due to fluoroquinolones, and in some cases even lead to retinal detachment. Well, that was a brief review of fluoroquinolones. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, give this video a like. Make sure to put any questions and comments down below. Share this video with your friends on Twitter, Google Plus, and Facebook. You can follow us on Twitter at iMedSchool or on Facebook and Google Plus at iMedicalSchool. And most importantly, subscribe. This is Dr. K, and I'll see you next time.